Praise the Lord. I thank God so much this morning. Being a Sunday for the Easter festivity, I greet you all in the name of Jesus Christ. My name is Reverend Simon Okonda of Redeemed Evangelistic Fellowship, Lakisama. Just to welcome you to this service today. The Lord is good, He has kept us through. The festivity time. Right now we are continuing to come to the end of it. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to say that thank you so much, even for being able to listen to us, even for tuning into this forum, that we may be able to share shortly concerning the resurrection of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to thank God that the Bible from the beginning was giving hope to humanity. And even as men ran out of the way, they went out and did things that were not evil or that were not right, still God was having a hope for humanity. God was having a plan. And God gave man opportunity that man should try their best, that man should try what they can do to be able to make themselves better. But it did not work. Praise the name of the Lord. Maybe just before I continue, I want to read a verse from the book of Mark chapter 16, from verse 1 downwards. We shall share shortly as the Lord will lead us. The Bible says, "And when the Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, brought sweet spices that they might come and anoint him. And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they came unto the sepulchre at the rising of the sun. And they said among themselves, who shall roll away the stone from the door of the sepulchre? And when they looked, they saw that the stone was rolled away, for it was very great." Praise the name of the Lord. There is something I want us to understand here. These are people who are with Jesus. And they had every account of what he had promised, and that he said that after 3 days he shall rise up again. But then we are seeing a situation here whereby they are coming with the spices, with the oil, to anoint the body of Christ. According to them, they didn't believe that it was possible that Christ could rise up again. I want to tell you today, this has been a problem in the world over. There are people who have denied up to today that Christ never rose. Even the ones who are very close to him, if they could still even come ready to anoint him, meaning that men has always had a problem of unbelief. I want to thank God that if this thing has happened to men who are with the Lord, but still it happened that what he said was true, then even us, whatever may look impossible with God, it's always going to be possible. The things that the Lord has promised in our lives, they shall come to pass. Praise the name of the Lord. They are saying that they are coming to anoint the body of Christ. And they even ask themselves, who shall roll the stone away from the sepulchre for us? You know, there are so many things we worry about in our lives. There are so many things we are so keen. We are trying to use our own means to overcome. And I think if these women could have seen a person, maybe or men on the way, they would have told them, come and help us. Because they think that maybe help must always come from the sources that we know. But the time they went there, the time they came to the sepulchre, the stone was rolled away. Praise the name of the Lord. What does it feel, sir? So you see, I'm trying to talk about a situation of people who are very close to Jesus. And it's like they didn't understand that the resurrection was a reality. Praise the name of the Lord. And I thank God that just from what we have seen here, is that even when the Bible says that we shall, just because he has died, our lives have been hid with him in glory. And the time when he appears, we shall appear with him also. So that even if people shall die, they shall rise up again. Praise the name of the Lord. In the book of Thessalonians, the Bible talks about the time when people began to die. People became worried that now the promises that we were given, are they going to happen? But the Bible says in the book of Thessalonians that do not be ignorant concerning those that are asleep. Meaning that the Bible is telling us that whatever God has promised in His word, it can never fail to take place. Praise the name of the Lord. So even during this Easter, I want to encourage you that whatever the Lord has in store for us, whatever He has promised in our lives, it does not matter how men may look at it. It does not matter how history or even science or even physics or whatever it is that men want to put in front may want to look like. It can never deny the truth of the Lord. So the Bible continues to say here, and entering into the sepulchre, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a long white garment, and they were afraid. And when they got into the sepulchre, they found that there's somebody seated there in white apparel, and they became afraid. Because you see that, you can see that fright, or maybe I can say that fear, has always driven the hearts of men. And as long as fear drives people, as long as fear is driving people, you'll find that we are not able to make proper judgment. Even during this time when I'm talking now, we are during the time of the corona pandemic, where when fear has taken control, fear has taken control of the hearts of men. Even the great and the mighty are afraid. And let me tell you that during this moment, even the people where people could run to, countries where people could run for refuge, where they thought that it was safer, it's no longer safe. Praise the name of the Lord. A time comes when the Lord puts everything at play. Everything becomes plain. That now everybody must realize there is a God who has a hand in what happens in the land of the living. Let me tell you right now that it's God who is in control. It's Him who is in control. There's somebody who said that, sang one day and said that he has the whole world in His hands. He's controlling everything in His hands. Right now, let me tell you that unless the Lord controls what's going on, there is no refuge for any person. Praise the name of the Lord. Even the foundations have been shaken. Foundations of medicines have been shaken. Foundations of economies, foundations of knowledge and education and research have been shaken. But the Lord has shown that all people are equal. A time comes when all people become equal. What is first? I want to thank God so much because our God is never impartial. Our God is never impartial. The thing we don't need to have is to have fear. The Bible says that when they saw the person in the white apparel, they were frightened, or they were afraid. Praise the name of the Lord. And he said unto them, the person said unto them, be not afraid. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, which was crucified. He's risen. He is not here. Behold the place where they laid him. In fact, he showed them where they laid him. Meaning that that which had been promised by the Lord, it came to pass. That the Lord had risen from the dead. He had defeated death. You know, death does not have power over him again. Death could not control him, could not confine him in death. Because he was above death. Praise the name of the Lord. And then the Bible says that he told them that he, go your way, tell his disciples and Peter, that he goes before you into Galilee. There shall you see him, as he said unto you. You know why they are saying that? Tell the disciples and Peter. Because Peter is a person who denied Christ 3 times. He denied him because he could not believe that anything was going to come out. So he denied the Lord 3 times. So that you're telling them, go tell the disciples and tell Peter also, even him who denied him, that he has risen and he's going before you to Galilee. Praise the name of the Lord. So the Bible says here that they went out quickly and fled from the sepulchre, for they trembled and were amazed, neither said they anything to any man, for they were afraid. Look at this thing here. In fact, even after that testimony of somebody in white apparel, whom we know it was an angel, telling them what to do, still they went their way, they were afraid. They never told any man. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Let me tell you that fear It's a big problem. If we face the world with fear, and that's why we see even in the Bible, even the servants of the Lord. I remember the time when David was dying. He told his servant, his son Solomon, not to be afraid. He told him just to believe in the Lord, to believe in the Lord who has been with him throughout, to believe that the Lord can never let him down. And any time that people are being given an assignment, they are also being reminded that do not be afraid. Because as long as you are afraid, you know where there is fear, then faith becomes ineffective. Faith cannot work in an environment of fear. So you find that these people, after having an encounter which was so supernatural, they could still not believe. They were still being led by fear. You see, where fear is prevailing, then faith becomes limited. Because now they could not even be able to express themselves. What they could not even say what they have seen because of fear. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to tell you that our God, whatever he has promised us, it shall come to pass. It does not matter how long it takes. That's why Habakkuk says in the book of Habakkuk chapter 1, he says that even if the vision may tarry, it begins from chapter 1, chapter 2, says that even if the vision may tarry, it shall come to pass. Praise the name of the Lord. There are things that even if they may look like they have taken time, they may look like they have taken moments, they have taken time, but if it has come from the mouth of the Lord, it shall come to pass. We remember the times of Samaria where they were being told that tomorrow food will be here at a cheap price. People could not believe it. But because the word had come from the Lord, you know, people could not, were deemed to be useless. They were moved by the Spirit of God. They've said that we cannot stay here until we die. We are going to the camp of the Syrians. And by their taking step, they were not afraid. Imagine people who should have been more afraid were not afraid. And they went to the camp of the Syrians. The Syrians ran away. And these people brought salvation to the whole of Samaria. Let me tell you that where there is fear, there are many things that cannot happen in our lives as long as fear is prevailing. But there are people who took a step out of fear. They said that we are not going to fear. We are going to take a step. I remember people like David. David was a small young man. He was not trained in warfare. He was not a soldier by the time the giant Goliath was exalting himself. But this man, he moved with boldness and he confronted that giant because fear was not his portion. I want to tell you that whatever is happening today, let me tell you that even this moment of the corona pandemic, where things are happening, I know there are times during the first wave, people are saying that who has ever seen a person, who has even heard somebody who has been mentioned to have corona. But right now, let me tell you that those are not fables, they are stories. It's now a reality. We have seen people, great men, people, men and women, young and old, dying out of this pandemic. It's coming, it is sweeping like a devil. But let me tell you, we are not going to be afraid. We are going to stand our ground because our God is with us. Our God is going to fight for us. Let's make sure that fear does not become our portion. Because whenever there is fear, then the faculties of our body, our mind, our system becomes, you know, disabled. But we shall trust in the Lord. We shall confront whatever comes our way in the Lord. Let me tell you, God never told us that we shall not have problems. God never told us we shall not be sick. God never told us we shall not be beaten, we shall not be fought. God never told us our things will never be taken away. But he told us that even when we shall go through the waters, he shall be there with us. Even when we shall go be thrown into the den of the lions, he shall be there with us. Let me tell you, the Bible says that from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violence shall take it by force. Let me tell you that we are not going to fear. We are going, whatever it comes, we are going to confront it with the Lord. We are going to say that as long as the Lord is on our side, we are not going to be afraid. We are confronting every power. We are confronting every force. We are confronting every spirit, every demon. We are not going to be afraid. Let me tell you, we are not of them that run back to perdition. We are them that are going to continue up to the saving of the soul. Let me tell you that fear has been a problem in the world. But I can tell you that we shall not fear. That their people stood their ground. I remember Abraham, just our household, went to fight five kings in the valleys of Sodom and Gomorrah to save his cousin Lot. Because this man was fearless. This man did not fear. This man was not anxious. This man knew that I have to stand my ground. This man understood that the war does not belong to men. The war belongs to God. There's a level whereby when the warfare arises, there's a way you can do our things. It shifts from being in the realm of men. It goes into the realm of God. And God begins to fight. And I want to thank God that there's a time when God told Joshua, there's no man that shall ever stand before you all the days of your life. Not that Joshua was so strong, not that you're so big, not that you're so experienced, but because the Lord was going to be with him. Praise the name of the Lord. One as first son. I want to tell you one thing, brethren, that after that, on verse 9, the Bible says that now, when Jesus was risen early in the first day of the week, he appeared first to Mary Magdalene, out of whom he had cast seven demons. He appeared to a lady. Praise the name of the Lord. One as first son. He appeared to this lady, Mary Magdalene. And remember, the same Mary Magdalene are among the people who had gone to anoint Jesus at the sepulchre. And remember, it's the same Mary Magdalene who had used her oil, very expensive oil, to wipe the feet of Jesus Christ. She was so dear. She loved the Lord so much because of what the Lord had done to her. I don't know what God has done in your life. I don't know what you can stand and say that because of this, I can go out of my way. I can take an extra step to ensure that I do something because of what he has done for me. So you see, the Bible says that and she went and told them that had been with him, and they mourned and wept, and they, when they had heard that he was alive and had been seen of her, believed not. Praise the Lord. You can see the problem of unbelief. Even after she has told them again. In fact, this is the second encounter of Magdalene, Mary Magdalene meeting Jesus. The first time at the sepulchre, they didn't believe, didn't tell anybody. Now here she has been, the Lord has spoken to her. Now she has told the people whom she was with, and they do not believe. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, there are things which are true, and it does not matter whether you believe it or not. You believing it or not believing does not change the truth. Because the Lord is God. And whatever has been spoken in his word, it shall come to pass. So even if you say you want to bring arguments, you know, you want to us to prove, you know, you want us to, you know, to expound. I know there's so much English nowadays, so you know, trying to do, let me tell you, it does not matter. But the truth is, whether you accept it or not, the truth remains the truth. Praise the name of the Lord. So the Bible says here, after that, he appeared in another form unto two of them as they walked and went into the country. And they went and told it unto the residue, neither believed they them. Hallelujah. You can understand what I'm talking about here. Afterward, he appeared unto the 11 as they sat at meat, and braided them with their unbelief and hardness of their heart, because they believed not them which had seen him after he was risen. In fact, he even went to the 11. Even the 11 still could not believe. Praise the name of the Lord. They could not believe because they had been told by people what has been seen, that they have seen the Lord, that they have seen a testimony, but they could still not be. And now the Lord rebukes them. The Lord is still rebuking us today about our unbelief. In fact, if we could believe the Lord enough, if we could do enough to believe the Lord, we could change this world. Let me tell you, the world we are living in, it's like we are believers who are not believing. We are believing God by denying the power thereof. We are not able to express our God, we are not able to sell our God to the people who are around us, because we are also full of unbelief. Praise the name of the Lord. But then in the same time the Lord gives us the Great Commission. He's telling us that in verse 15, and he said unto them, go ye unto all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Praise the Lord. He's saying that go preach the gospel to every creature, meaning that every person. You don't need to select who to speak the gospel to. We don't need to see and say that who ni kimubiria hata amini, this one cannot believe. No, it's not your business. Your business is to preach to every creature. And the Bible is saying, he that believes and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believes not shall be damned. Meaning that he who does not choose to believe, praise the Lord, he's already destroyed, he's already damned himself. It's not you, it is him. Because God has given us what we call the will power. The power to choose, the power to make a decision. You know, just like what we are three in one. We have this body with the five senses. Then we have the soul. The soul has the will, it has the mind, it has the emotions. And then we have the spirit made of the worship and the unction. And then you find that the power to choose or the power to decide what we want is within our soul. We can make a decision. We can make our will. So the gospel is preached, and the people who believe, they are willing, they have made their will positive. Praise the name of the Lord. But those ones who refuse, you see, God did not make us to be like automatons, that we just have to respond to things without decision. Whatever we find ourselves in is whatever we have chosen. Praise the Lord. And then he said that, and these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name they shall cast out devils, they shall speak with the new tongues. They shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not harm them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. You see, the Lord is telling us things that are going to follow those that believe. Praise the name of the Lord. You don't need to follow after signs, but signs follow after those who believe. The biggest miracle in a life of a human being is to believe. Because the time you believe, it's like you have opened the door of the signs and wonders following you. Because signs and wonders are accompaniments to somebody who believes. Somebody who believes, it comes with a package. The package that comes with a believer is that you will speak in other tongues. You shall lay your hands upon the sick and they shall be healed. You, even if you take any deadly thing, it shall not harm you. You shall prophesy. You shall do great things. Those are things that are going to accompany people who believe. Let me tell you, the gospel is great. The gospel is something that is worthy. The gospel is something that people have ever tested it. There's somebody who sang and said that njone mwonje mwone vile Yesu ni mwema. Meaning that just come and test and see how good God is. Meaning that it's only people who have received the gospel who understand the joy in it. Understand the fulfillment that comes out of the believing in the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. And then number 5, verse 19 says that, so then, after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven and sat on the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word with the signs following them. Amen. So let me tell you, this is the time not to sit down and cry about a Lord who died, he was arrested, he was beaten, he was buried. This is the time for us to arise and do for God. If actually you love him, you do the Great Commission. That's the thing he left us with. In fact, he didn't tell us to remain crying for him. In fact, there's even a time when people are crying, they told them, no, do not cry for me. Cry for yourselves and your children. Because he was fulfilling his purpose. What has first happened? And let me tell you one thing, my brethren. You see, the Lord Jesus Christ was not crucified because he was disabled. Not that he could not defend himself. Because there's a time when Peter cut somebody with a sword. He tells him, no, that's not the warfare we are fighting. If I wanted, I could have called legions of angels to come and fight for me. But he gave himself so that you and me can receive what God will be able to receive. Praise the name of the Lord. So even as we celebrate our Easter festivity, remember we have an assignment to do. We have a job to do. We have work to do. If you have ever spoken, I don't know how many of us have ever spoken to anybody about Christ. You have never even testified, telling somebody that the Lord loves you, giving somebody hope. Let me tell you, people are dying at a very fast rate. Look in the whole world today. The devil is literally harvesting people. How many of those people are dying without the hope of Christ? And what have you done? Or you are still saying that I'm still waiting for time. I'm waiting for an appropriate time. I'm waiting for the right time. I'm waiting for the time when I should do it. I'm still young. I'm still inexperienced. I still don't have what it takes. Let me tell you, God does not use people who are qualified. God takes the unqualified to qualify them. You only become qualified when you are doing it. Praise the name of the Lord. Let me tell you, even as we didn't begin, we were not people who could not even be able to speak much before people. But the time we began, the Lord has put utterance in our mouths. We are able to speak. We are able to explain ourselves in the simplest way we can. And because it's not all about us, the Lord makes it to be understood. It is all about the Lord and not about us. Let me tell you that this is the time when people should wake up more than ever. Because this time the devil is harvesting people. This coronavirus is killing people day and night. Look in the news. It's so terrifying. People don't even want to look at the news anymore. It is so afraid. People. I remember there's a time when people are saying, we don't want the vaccination. We are not going to be vaccinated. But now people are running for it like nobody's business. Because now fear is driving them. People are living in fear. People are living in horror. They are terrified. People are anxious because they have no hope. Let me tell you, we have a message of hope. Tell the people. Praise the name of the Lord. That the Lord is in control. The Lord is in control. Hallelujah. If there is something you can do for somebody, tell people that the Lord loves them. Let them give their life to Jesus. In fact, the more people are running for vaccination, if they could be running for Christ like that, I'm telling you, this world would be different. Praise the name of the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. May the Lord bless you so much. May the Lord strengthen you. During this time of Easter, send somebody a message of hope. Not only food. There are times when people have eaten food, they even don't have appetite. People need appetite of the word of God. Tell them something about the Lord. Let people give their life. Let people understand that there is hope in Christ. Praise the name of God. Who died and he rose again. Hallelujah. And because he rose and because he lives, we shall live again. Hallelujah. What has your son? And let me tell you one thing. Some of us people have lost some of our loved ones because it is common knowledge. It is in the common domain that people have lost lives. We have even lost men of God, mighty men of God. We have lost great evangelists. We have lost fathers, bishops. We have lost pastors. We have lost fathers, sisters, uncles. We have lost mothers. We have lost our loved people. Let me tell you, it is not all over. It's not all over. It's not all over. The Lord is on our side. Let's believe in God. If they died in the Lord, we shall see them again. God bless you. God bless you. Amen.
Prayer.
Let me pray. Our Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord, you are the King, you are the Master. You are the great I am, Jehovah, Lord. You are the hope of glory. You are the Lord who is our strength. Father, during this time of Easter, in the midst of the greatest pandemic ever, Lord, I pray that shower your hope upon your people. Many people have become hopeless. They are full of fear. They are frightened. They don't know what to do. Some of them are literally hiding, because they cannot express themselves. Father, this time intervene. Bring hope. We stand against the spirit of corona. The sickness, pandemic of corona is a demon. You are not going to live with our people anymore. We destroy you from your root. In Jesus' mighty name, I destroy you from your strength. Wherever you are, whatever reasons you came to do, you are defeated. This world is the Lord's. It is not the world of the devil, not a world of sickness. I pray, Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, you are the hope of glory. minister to us, minister to us. Save us from this pandemic. Save our people, save our nation, save your servants, save King of Glory Africa, save the whole.